So I am going to my downloads and I am installing my Python. See, this is the path where my Python is going to install, and please click on this add Python 3.82 path. Please add this. Okay, do add this. Okay, now click on install now and let it install. So now you can see, close it. Go to command prompt. And type out here Python and press enter. See, it is giving me three arrows with the version of Python, all information. See, it is beautifully installed. It has been installed. Remember, you need to click on that checkbox. See, we can write code on command prompt also, but we are not going to write our code on command prompt. We'll be using another IDE to write the code, but this verifies that we have written or we have installed our Python success. Now we will be writing code somewhere else. So I will be using IDE. So what is IDE? It is Integrated Development Environment. So it is an environment where we can write our code. We can debug it. Okay. We can attach files. Okay, there are multiple functionality available with IDE. So there are basically two IDE available to work with Python. Okay, so let's see. First is PyCharm. It is one of the famous IDE to work with Python. Okay, see, it also comes in two flavors. One is community version. Which comes free of cost, okay, and another is paid version. See, there are some advantages of paid version, always are there. Actually, we get benefits of HTML and more additional functionality is available with this paid version. Okay, second famous one, see, we work with it in Java also, that is Eclipse. Fine, see, Eclipse is very much famous for Java, but if I install a plugin in it, then I am able to easily work with Python on Eclipse. So let's see PyCharm. So just go here and download. PyCharm. No, what's the spelling? Yeah, PyCharm. Okay. So as soon as you click enter, you will see that. Click on this site. So now you can see there are two things available. One is professional version and another is community version. Okay. So if you download community version, see, it is all. It is showing me for pure Python development, means we will be only able to work with Python here. Okay, and if you take this paid version, see, it is given, it is both for scientific and web Python, and it is providing with an additional facility with HTML, JS and SQL support. And similarly, if you talk about Eclipse, it is absolutely free. Okay, Google it out. Go to the site eclipse.org. Okay. Go inside it. See, you can download it. See, you can download according to your language demand. Okay, fine, you can download it from this eclipse.org. fine, don't worry, I will let you know everything. So let's work on these editors. So I am downloading this community version of PyCharm. Okay, click here. See, as soon as I click, it is establishing the connection. Okay. And it started downloading. It is somewhat big, that is 270 MB. Okay, it will take some time. See that it got downloaded. Now you need to install it. See, I am also configuring everything fresh for this training. Okay, so you guys can understand the things from the beginning. Okay, so I am now configuring it. Click on next. Next. I am creating next. Install. Let it install. See, it will take some time to install. Okay, let it install and click on finish. Okay, so I have successfully installed our PyCharm. Fine. So now let's launch it. So see, we are launching it for first time. So this window will come. Okay, confirm it, continue. Okay, don't send. Now we are successfully launching our PyCharm. Escape. So as soon as you launch, it will show us three options: create new project, open, and get version. So we are creating first time, click on open. Okay. So now we need to create our workspace. What is workspace? Where our code will exist. Okay. So let's take it as, let me make it in my videos only. So here. See, I will be creating this code at the same location. So I'm making it so that you guys can take this course also. Okay, where my videos are. Fine. Okay. Here, what I do? Let me create a new folder here. PyCharm code. Okay, I have created with this name. Go here again, flash it. Okay, okay, let it configure. See, PyCharm started. Fine, it is started and it is doing initializing everything. Fine, see, it is still doing something. So now let's create a new project. How can you create a new project? See, just for that we need to right click on it. Let this thing configure the Python interpreter. Wait for it. Okay. Okay. See, Python has been configured to our project. Okay. It is now it will scan. See, these things mainly happens when we do a configuration for the first time. So it will always take some time. There is our project, that is PyCharm code. Right click on it. Okay, first thing you need to do, right click on it. Fine. Here you can see, go to new, and here we want to create a new package. So let's create a new Python package. I have clicked on new Python package, name as demo. Press enter. Now see, my new package has been created. Now just right click on it. Now new file. Okay, give the file name as QA Guides. As what you want. This is my company name, that's fine.